fertilization occurs when the male sperm and female ovum unite. What results is an entity called a zygote, a one-cell biological entity, a stage of development medically through which each of us has passed, just as we've gone through infancy, childhood, and adolescence separately. Both ovum and sperm, which are genetically each a part of its owner, cease to exist at the moment of conception and a new entity is conceived. The zygote is born. The zygote fulfills the four criteria needed to establish the core biological life norms, metabolism and vital growth, reaction to stimuli and reproduction. The zygote is a product of human parents, thus human by custom. Also resulting from the union of the female ovum, which contains 23 chromosomes, and the male sperm, 23 chromosomes, and this conceptus is a new, although tiny, individual with its own genetic code of 46 chromosomes, a code that is neither his mother's nor his father's, it's originally new. And from this point till the child matures and becomes an old man, no sort of new genetic information resumes. No new info is needed for this unborn entity to be a human. Genetic makeup is also determined at conception, no confusion. This genetic code determines to a great extent his own functional, individual physical characteristics like selected bone structure, eye color, gender, the color of your hair and skin, your susceptibility to certain diseases is all there at conception. So, at conception, the genotype or inherited real-life characteristics of humans are established and secure in him, and will remain in force for this person's entire life. The unborn shares the same final right nature of all human beings and is now unlike any individual who has ever been conceived before. And even more is unlike any born who will be conceived again unless they are identical twins. The only thing the child needs for prime development, as with the rest of our society, is oxygen and food and water. Since the child or conceptus, like the newborn, the infant, and the adolescent, needs only to develop in line with its design nature, which, as you guessed, clearly is there at conception. If it is wrong to kill a newborn 2 days old, why is it okay if we killed her 72 hours ago? If it is wrong to kill a three-month-old baby who's been born, why is it all right to kill that same being 4 months earlier? The little baby's only less mature inside the womb than if he is born in terms of development, dependency, and size. Considerations that are not morally relevant when it comes to a born individual's rights. A two-year-old does not have fewer of a known right to life than a grown adult simply because he's smaller in size, development, and dependency. So it's the same as with a smaller fetus developing. Also, doctors say that a single thread of DNA that these babies contain even make up an amazing piece of reason and data. See, one human cell contains the information equivalent to 600,000 pages with 500 words per page. Then how fascinating. One single cell of a baby is equal to a library of 1,000 deep volumes of specific genetic information wrote on the DNA of that child who is ready to grow, all available right there at conception. The stored knowledge at conception in the new baby's library of instruction is 50 times more than that contained in the Encyclopedia Britannica full set. Remember them? How amazing. All of that information inside just one strand of DNA from that small conceptus you want to kill out of convenience. A person did not come from a zygote. She was once a zygote. She did not come from an embryo. She was once an embryo. And finally, she did not come from a fetus. She was once a fetus. She did not come from an adolescent. She was once an adolescent. You see this? In conclusion, the pro-life advocate believes it's all quite established that full humanness begins at the life status of conception, and it matters, yes. Because at the moment of conception, a separate human individual then is born and infused with its own genetic code imbued in them. Just like us, she needs only food, water, and shelter, and oxygen to grow and develop into what God has well established in heaven. Like the infant, the child, and the adolescent thee, Conceptus is a being who is in the process of becoming. The Conceptus is the sexual product of human parents and a developing Conceptus. That is, the sexual product of members of a particular species is itself an individual member of them, no matter if it's popular or PC. That same being that begins as a zygote would continue on to birth, adolescence, and adulthood. Welcome to truth.com.